Hey everyone, and welcome back to another new Sims 3 speedbuild house building video in which I build a house called Modern Pearl, which is a big house which is located in the Sims 3 store world Monte Vista. The house has two bedrooms and two bathrooms, and to be honest, I think the house has the best interior of one of my houses ever yet. But you will see the interior of this house later, of course. So here you see me doing the pool of this house, which turned out to be very special because the pool is very big and it goes under the house, and it's located on two stories, or well, two levels you can better say, I think. And also it has windows, as you can see here, and I think that gives kind of a cool effect. Also you see those floors going over the a swimming pool. Here you see me making the pool a little bit bigger, so as you can see, it's a very big pool. And yeah, I think that pool turned out to look very cool. So here you see me doing the pool on the on another level, as I said before. And I think, yeah, the pool is kind of a main thing of this house. So here you see me continuing with the shape of the whole house, just adding some stairs and stuff. I didn't really know what to do with the entrance, so I decided to do something like this. I'll change the walls later. I already changed it. And so here you see me adding some stairs. Those didn't really work, so I decided to kind of change that because, yeah, it didn't work, as you can see, with the pool. So I decided to just not make some stairs over there. Or did I? I didn't know. I think I decided to not place stairs there in the end. Yes, that's right. So here we continue with the shape of the house, and then we're almost finished the shape, I think, and then we can start with the walls of the house. So here you see me doing some stuff, but we didn't really keep that in the end. So here you see me kind of doing constraint flow, elevation falls all the time, messing around with those stairs, changing the terrain a bit, which I think turned out to look pretty nice over around the house. So here you see me adding some walls. Here we continue with the walls. So yeah, I will also take this video to ask you something, because as some of you might know, I have a Twitter and Facebook account for this channel, and there I post quite a lot, actually, especially on Twitter. I tweet previews of preview photos of new houses, actually, long before the speedbuild video is online. So if you check those, you already know what the house will look like before the video, or at least some previews of it. And also I say when I'm recording, or I, for example, give my opinion on new Sim 3 or Sims 4 related stuff, and I also just tweet some random personal things. So I'd really appreciate it if you would follow me there, because I really like to get a response on Twitter and Facebook. Yeah, just because I'm quite active on those things, especially on Twitter, as I said before. So here you see me adding the walls, doing some constraint floor, elevation fall stuff, and now we're going to add a second floor. So this house turned out to look or to be pretty big. It doesn't look pretty really big. Well, it does, but it doesn't look way too big, you know. It's just big, and it has two bedrooms, two bathrooms, so one main master bedroom and one child bedroom with a bunk bed. So here you see me adding the roof on the house, which was pretty difficult because I didn't really know what to do with it. But I think in the end the roof turned out to look very cool. So just like the color scheme of this house, which also turned out to look pretty nice. So as you might notice, I sound a little bit different because I'm kind of ill, or at least I don't know how you say that in English. Wait, let me search it. No, I'm not gonna search that now. How do you say that? I'm gonna try to search for it, what it's called, what I have. It's not something too serious, it's just, you know, my nose is, wait a second, I have Google Translate, it is, I have a cold, that's it, I kind of have a cold, it's not for very long yet, it came when I started recording this video for some reason. But anyway, you now know what I have, and I think it will be gone soon. Anyway, here you see me adding the fences around the house, which I think made the house look a little bit more modern, which I like. Oh, and by the way, the roof which we have on the house right now is not a final roof. I decided to make a kind of a lighter roof on the house because I thought it would look a little bit better with the colors of the walls. So here you see me adding the colors, or you see me changing the roof, and as you can see, it are not the colors I normally use. It are kind of it's yellow with red, orange kind of, and some wood, and I think that turned out to look very nice. Also, I got some comments saying on previous videos that usually the color schemes of my houses are kind of the same. And I think in this house that's not the case, because it turned out to look way different. So here you see me making a path to the garage and the entrance of the house. So adding some stones around there. I think, to be honest, that this garden turned out to look very cool, because it's very detailed. I did my best on it, and I think it turned out to look really cool. So yeah, I'm very happy with that. So here you see me adding some plants and some other, here you see me searching for a smaller of that palm tree kind of thing. Adding some other plants. Change the terrain a bit. As you can see, I add very many plants, but I think with this house that gives a very cool effect with some stones between it. So I'm very happy how this house turned out to look like. It was pretty difficult to build it because I had some constraint for elevation falls and the true stuff problems, and also I didn't really know what to do with the color scheme and the roof, and I think it turned out to look pretty cool. So I hope you think the same. So as you might already know, if you've been following my Let's Build a Dorm series, you know that I'm going to take a short break from doing videos here on YouTube for around 2-3 weeks, I think. This means that there will not be any series or anything else uploaded, except for the speed builds like this one. Those will still be uploaded, I think like 3-2 in total in those 2-3 weeks. And I do this because I have the feeling that you are kind of getting a little bit bored by all series I'm doing. And so it's not for me, because I still enjoy it, but I also want you to enjoy it, and I still want a great response on the videos, if you know what I mean. So that's why I decided to kind of make a break of, I think, 2 weeks, as I said before, for free. And then I will be back with some really cool Let's Build series. I hope you think the same. I think it is going to be awesome. So in these coming 2 weeks, I will have time to record that, and you know, you have time to watch some other stuff. And then when I'm back, you're excited for new videos again, or at least that's what I hope. So yeah, then you know why I'm not uploading very many videos the coming 2 weeks. And stay subscribed, of course, for the speedbirds, which will be uploaded like this one, because I will still be doing that, because I know everyone really likes those. And I think now you also have a little bit more time to watch those, because otherwise I uploaded a speed build, and the day after I already did a Let's Build series, so that it becomes a little bit too much to watch. So here you see me doing a really cool thing in the garden. I think, you know, it has a curved roof, and it will have kind of an eating terrace area, or at least that's what it's going to be. So as you can see, we already have quite many plants in the garden, and it's very detailed, so yeah, I think it looks pretty good, to be honest. So we add a fence over here, and then now we add some other plants. Add a palm tree. Now add a huge stone over there, which we will remove in a second, I think. So adding some other plants over there. As you can see, this house has very many plants, and that makes it detailed, I think. So changing the color of the pool a bit, because I didn't really like the color it had before, so I changed it to kind of what do you call it, a mosaic. I don't know if you call it in English like that, but you maybe recognize it or anything. So it becomes kind of a little bit darker, and I think that looks pretty cool. So also adding some cool lights for in the dark in the swimming pool, because I think it looks pretty cool if you have a nice lit up swimming pool. So adding some stones there between the two swimming pools, and on that area, open area, so you see over there, there will be a hot tub. Yes, that replaces it. And add some other palm trees and add some extra detailed stuff with some plants on it. So if you really like this house, you can of course download it. It is possible if you press the link in the description, and then you can just download it into your game. So yeah, if you like it, be sure you do that. And also, if you really like the video, please share it with everyone you know who likes Sims. Just do it. So yeah, here you see me making kind of a terrace, I think you call it, like that. Changing the stairs a bit. Had some problems over there. Later we fixed it, I think. So kind of doing some terrain changes, and now add a pond over there, just like we had in the front yard. Add some plants around it, some dirt around the pond, and some kind of stone terrain paint next to the swimming pool. So add some more plants. We add many plants in this house, I know. So we continue with the gardening over here, add some more plants again, and then some, I think some seconds, we'll go on to the interior of this house. So yeah, we finish the last things of the terrace over there in the by the pool area. Add some umbrellas. Change the color of the barbecue room. Add some other last plants. And in some seconds we go on to the interior. Or at least I hope. Yes, there we go. So I decided to do a time-lapse interior part, because it took very long to do the interior of this house. And if I would do it like I do the building of the house, it would take way too long, and I had to speed up it up way too much. So here you see a kind of before and after shot of a room. I think I pretty like that way. If you like it too, please say it in the comment section below. Here we make kind of a relaxed hobby area, and then this is the end of the video. Thanks for watching, and enjoy the rest of the video. Bye.